Okay, so next we have Shimon with the new sidebar and dialogue backend. So I have made you a presenter, Shimon.
Can you see? Can you see my screen?
Yes, perfect. I can see you and I can see your screen as well. So go ahead. Or maybe let's wait 1 minute, please. Just to be okay. Sure people are still arriving from lunch or from coffee time. Yeah, okay. Okay, you can go ahead.
Okay, so my name is Szymon Kłos, and in this talk, I will talk about our backend for the new sidebar and also dialogues. We call it in the code as Ingress Dialogues, and this is some kind of a framework to share the UI components between LibreOffice and Collabora Online. So this helps us to improve both products at the same time. So when we add a new feature in the UI, it appears in both LibreOffice and Collabora Online. For those who don't know how it works, the general idea is very simple. We take some UI component from the LibreOffice. We describe it in an abstract way in JSON format. Then we send this as a short message to the client web browser, where we can use different builders to create a completely new user interface. So we have a few of different builders. And for example, on mobile devices, we can present the sidebar as a mobile-friendly wizard. But on the desktop, we can show it more like a classic sidebar in the desktop application. JS Dialogues provides communication in both directions. So when user does some action on a mobile device, we send them the message back to the server, and we process that message in the original widgets. Initial idea was to add new functionality to the mobile client. We wanted to add advanced editing options for mobile devices. And for that, we reused the sidebar from LibreOffice, transformed to the mobile-friendly user. As you can see on the screen, we have big widgets, easy to tap using your fingers and touch devices. It's context dependent thanks to the sidebar, and we can do a lot of actions with that. But it had some disadvantages, but in the recent year, I fixed them while working on introducing the JS dialogues for sidebar and dialogues. First, I was focused on the optimization. In the past, we had to send the whole JSON for the full sidebar every time we did some action. So it's not optimal way to handling the actions. So I introduced three different types of messages. First, full window update. It's sent only one time when we create the new window, and it has all the widgets inside. But when we update one of the widgets, we send only the updated content. So that's the second type, single widget update. When we have some complex widgets, like for example, icon view, we can select some items inside of that widget. And for that purpose, we added action kind of messages, which is used only for the small actions where we when we want to, for example, change the selection. And we don't have to send all the JSON about what entries we have in that widget, only the position which changed. Thanks to that, we reduced the transfer size between the browser and server. Also, we receive updates faster because we don't have to waste time on generating full JSON. And also, dialog updates are better because we can update only one widget while we are typing, for example, in the input field. So we see the updates in the real time, not only after we finish the typing, like it was in the initial mobile wizard. Another optimization was using the shared queue within the one dialog. So all the widgets now send their messages to the queue, and in that queue we can reduce number of messages because we know that, for example, after full update, the previous updates are not needed anymore, so we can just remove them, or we can do other smart optimizations. We also generate JSON in a lazy way, so we generate it only just before sending, so we are sure that it's always up to date. That optimization was very useful for example, icon view, where we have a lot of custom drawn widget previews. And this widget was also missing in our JS dialog implementation on the online side. So I introduced that. And also, thanks to that, we can now have the Frontwork dialog in online. I also reused that widget in the notebook bar, improving the user experience when we have lots of different styles in the document. So now we can just scroll and look for a correct style. We don't have to click multiple times in some buttons. Other widget which was missing in our implementation on the online side was the trivia. It's the most complex widget, I think, because it can show the content in many ways. It can be a simple list box. It can be a tree with some checkboxes or without. It can show notes on demand, or even supports drag and drop. As you can see, we were able to introduce a few new features to the online thanks to that widget. We have new pivot table creator, improved auto filter dropdown, which now use the JS dialogs, and also we added named ranges support thanks to define and manage dialogs. Also, as you can see, pivot table dialog supports drag and drop. We can compose a new table just moving some entries around the available tribus inside this dialog. But the most visible feature I implemented during the last year was the native sidebar. Previously, we had a sidebar which is drawn on a canvas. It was just an image. Now we have native HTML controls, so it improves the user experience, for example, on touch devices, where we can have now the native list boxes. We can scroll them very easily. And also this improves the consistent look of the application because we can style the new sidebar with CSS. Sidebar uses a lot of dropdowns where we have more advanced editing options, and I had to implement that too for the framework. So now toolboxes and menu buttons support dropdowns. And also I improved sidebar a little bit because I added a new panel for fontwork editing. As you can see, we can change their shape or layout of the fontwork. These are all updates I did last year in JS Dialogs. I think now the framework looks almost complete. Probably we will reuse that in other dialogs too, which are not yet converted.
Thanks, Simon.